We are going to discuss about Unit 4 CNS. So it consists of message integrity, message authentication, cryptographic hash functions, digital signature and key management. Okay. So first, message integrity. Message integrity means when a message is transmitted from sender to receiver, it need to get transmitted without any modification. Then it achieves the integrity. Okay. So integrity means without being modified. So these are the attacks that can be done on integrity. That is modification, masquerading, replaying and repetition. These four attacks are discussed earlier in the unit 1. And then moving to the to provide security methods. There are four security methods. That is, one is document and fingerprint. So each document is attached with some fingerprint, so that by using biometric they can access the document. Okay. Next, message and message digest. It is electronic equivalent. So the given document is given and it is performed some cryptographic hash function and then it is converted into message digest. Okay. And message detection code, message authentication code. Message authentication code is when sender wants to send some information to the receiver, it will be done like this by sending a proof along with message. Okay. And message detection code is the device used for sending the proof. Message authentication means sending the proof with message authentication by including some proof to the message. The way of using the proof is message detection code. Okay. Next, coming to message detection code. So coming to message detection code, it involves when the sender, S means sender and R means receiver. So when sender wants to send the message to the receiver, he adds message detection code to the receiver. And receiver receives the message, and receiver also, when he received the message, he also generates his own message detection code. And he will authenticate both, like he will check his received message and his own method detection code. So if both are equal, there is no modification done. If they are not equal, modification is done. Okay, so this can be written for the question message detection code and how to identify modification of a message. Next, coming to message authentication code. Here the sender and receiver will have security keys, and security keys should be equal and they shouldn't be shared. They are kept as secret, and by sharing the data for sender to receiver, the complete data should be in a ciphertext. That is, it should be encrypted. And receiver converts this ciphertext by using security key. Okay. Next, cryptographic hash function. Cryptographic hash function provides security when A is transmitting the data to B or B is transmitting the data to A. So there will be different sizes of bits, like small, large, exact. So if you want, if there is 300 bits and if you want to make it 256, it need to be compressed. So these methods are done by using message digest, which is using a hash function, okay, to compress. There are MD1, MD2, MD3 in message digest, and then secure hash function. It contains some secure hash function that will be applied to compress it. Okay, and it has 128, 256, 512 and so on particular sized bits. Okay. And next, coming to message encryption. So here the message is there, it should be hashed with some encryption key. So here up to now the message is hashed and encrypted. So what will be there? Cipher and hash code. Okay. Now by using this private key, it should be known what the message should be known by using its receiver's private key. And here sender will send the message using hash function, which generates the hash code, and then message is given to the encrypted by key. Ciphertext is sent to the receiver, and receiver decrypts by using the generated hash code using hash function. Okay, digital signature. Digital signature comes under the authentication in real-time application. It is the signature on the paper, but it is more secured way. So here actually the document contains the message and signature, but in digital transmission it has to be in two documents. One document is for message and the second document is for signature. Receiver should maintain a file that contains the sender's signature, and the complete digital signature is one-to-one relation. Attacks. Coming to the attacks, there are known key attack, known message attack, and chosen message attack. Okay. And next, entity authentication. It is one party should provide identity to the another party, that is called entity authentication. It can be a person, client, or a server. Here A is called, like the receiver is called the verifier and sender is called as a claimant. Who prove his identity is called sender. Who should prove others' identity is called verifier, that is receiver. Okay, here Alice is called claimant and verifier is Bob, because Alice is sending the message to Bob. What is the difference between data authentication and identity authentication? Until this authentication is completed, Alice and Bob should be online. When it is entity authentication, there is no need of the sender to be online when it is data authentication. I have given some examples, you can refer it. Okay. And next, coming to security methods for entity authentication. There is password authentication, which is fixed password, and another one is one-time password. Fixed is longer period and one-time is very shorter period. Password approach. There are four approaches. First one is password authentication. User will create a password and keep in the database. So every time when the system is asking the password, the user will write the password and the database password also will be alternatively checked by it. Okay, so here there are some attacks in the password authentication, like guessing, they can be stolen or they can be hacked and accessed, and eavesdropping means by keyboard sounds. Second one is hash value method. Every password has some hash function. Okay, third one is salting. This is user will have the password and system also will password that is related to the user password. Fourth one is digital technique. It contains something known and something possessed. Key management. The last topic. Key management. Key management is also called as key distribution. Here we have public key distribution and private key distribution. Public key distribution means public announcement. Public directory. Here all the public keys of different users will be in one directory. Public key authority. Here between two users it acts as a mediator and will generate the keys. Next, public key distribution. Here we have public or secret key. Here every secret key can be accessed with. If P is having some secret key, by using this he will access, along with this private key, he should have B's public key. Okay, it should be a vice versa when it alters for 1-to-1. Okay, and last one is private key with authentication and confidentiality. So this is the complete notes for 4th unit. And I will also attach the PDF file in the description. Thank you.